Hello everyone, we're here at Mobile World Congress again in 2024 in Barcelona, and I'm really pleased to have Anthropic and SK Telecom with us to talk about large language models and how to specifically apply them to the telco sector. So just to kick things off, please introduce yourselves, your roles, and what you're trying to achieve in cooperation with us.
I'm Nirav Kingsland, the head of business development at Anthropic. And what we're trying to do in this partnership is take our large language foundation model and fine tune it specifically for the telco industry.
Hi, my name is Will Cho, VP of strategic partnership at SK Telecom. My job is to identify key use cases and develop this telco specific LLM together with Anthropic and AWS.
Pleased to have both of you here. My name is Samir Buyuru. I run the business development and strategy for the telecommunications sector here at AWS. So let's get into it. We've seen the rise of LLMs. But now, when I talk to our customer base, our mutual customer base, including SK Telecom, the rise of the telco LLM, the rise of the industry-specific LLM, is absolutely top of mind for most of our customers. Obviously, we are doing a lot at AWS to democratize AI, making models such as Anthropic's Claude 2 and future generations available on Bedrock and on SageMaker Jumpstart and so on, innovating on the silicon, the chipsets, so that you can actually train and infer up to 40% faster and cheaper. I would love to understand how you guys are using those capabilities to build these industry-specific models. If you could just focus on maybe the telco industry, because that is why we're here, that would really help. Maybe, Nirav, you start?
Anthropic's base model, we're trying to build the safest, most capable large language model in the world. And we think we've done that, and we've built it in large part on top of AWS because of the security and speed and scale that you mentioned. But when we look at industries that are moving very fast, we don't think the base model's enough. We need to find partners that have industry-specific data that we can use to further train our models so they can be better for that industry. And Will can talk a little bit more, but in SKT, we've just found an incredible industry partner.
Yeah. Last year, our CEO announced that SK Telecom was going to transform itself into an AI company. And we decided to make a strategic investment into Anthropic. And coupled with that, we decided to jointly develop telco-specific LLM together with Anthropic. And at the same time, by tapping into AWS's best-in-class cloud capabilities, we wanted to create cohesive partners forged by these three strong partners and tapping into their respective strengths. So by creating this telco domain tailored LLM for telco industry, we can create multiple benefits for all parties involved.
And Nirav, could you talk a little bit about the TelCloud version of it?
Sure. So what we did with SKT is we took very specific telecom data, like customer transcripts, where we took the personal identification out of them. And then we had SKT's best agents evaluate those transcripts. And so they would tell us which transcripts were great examples of unbelievable customer service, and then we would train Claude on that data. And every time we got data from SKT, we saw improvements in our base model's performance on these telco-specific evaluations.
Just set the stage for what we're seeing in terms of the highest velocity use cases out there in the telco industry. One is obviously the customer service chatbot aspects of it. I think that is where almost every single telco has started. But we are starting to see higher value use cases. We're starting to see customer-specific LLMs deployed at the edge, mm-hmm. on device, whether the device is one of our Alexa smart home devices, or whether it's your handset, or whether it's your car, to provide that custom experience. And then finally, the network operations themselves. We see in RAN management, in network root cause analysis, multiple applications of this of these LLMs, simplifying the operator experience. How do you guys see TelCloud and, in general, the industry-specific LLMs contributing to the acceleration of these three vectors?
We looked into open possibilities of how to leverage this AI technology to address telco's use cases. And it drawn on us that there are three different phases of innovation we can actually accomplish using LLM. So the flagship use case, as you mentioned, is starting from customer service. Specifically, telco LLM-enabled AI contact center seems to be the right point to start. And a lot of other peer telcos actually agreed to focus on that use case. So by having tailored LLM equipped with telco domain knowledge and telco's business logic, we can empower call center agent, getting rid of those huge cognitive workload and just focus on customer experience. That is one benefit. But at the same time, from customer point of view, leveraging this call center agent coupled with AI-powered chatbot, we can get rid of the lead time for them to resolve outstanding issues. But at the same time, for the companies, like peer telco companies, they're going through a lot of training issues to retain this contact center agent and boost the productivity of call center agents. So all these powered by this telco LLM, we see multiple synergies came across. And the next use case we are focusing on is how to improve our existing B2C customer-facing services using this LLM. So we call it as a better telco use case. For example, we decided to develop AI-powered, intelligent, and responsible message services. So in Korea, phishing and spamming is a social issue. Right?
Worldwide, yeah.
Worldwide.
Yeah.
So by leveraging this LLM's capabilities and in very close collaboration with Department of Police, we could actually recognize the malicious patterns of these phishing and spamming attempts and then blocking those attempts at the network level, ensuring customers actually enjoying very safe environment to use these matching services. That's another use case. And last but not least, we decided to take a step ahead and then try to develop personal AI assistant service in Korea. So one of the use case it draws a lot of attention in the market was customer can opt in to record their voice call. And then using on-device capabilities, we can actually transcribe their call and then identifying specific actions to be taken. For example, you and I decided to go have a lunch next week. It recognized, okay, do you want me to actually create coordinated schedule? Or do you want me to actually find a restaurant? That is kind of extension of this LLM to assist users to address their daily routine and challenges and activities.
That sounds amazing. But it also opens up the fear of the unknown for consumers, right? So as we look at training these telco LLMs in Europe, right, what are the key concerns you heard around privacy, security, and how specifically are you training these LLMs to address that, but not slow down the pace of innovation that customers like SKT need?
When you fine-tune a model, you want to make sure you don't have personal identification in it. So that's something we've done very closely with SKT, is make sure all the information is generic and doesn't tie back to any specific person. The second thing is once that model is fine-tuned and trained, you want to make sure the model itself is very secure. And that's where our partnership with AWS comes in. We can host the model on AWS Bedrock, and that creates a secure environment for any telco in the world to call the model and harness the AI technology. And when we're partnering with SKT on those three use cases that Will mentioned, what we're really looking for is for them to teach us what excellence looks like in the telco industry. So for each of those use cases, they'll give us thousands of examples of what great looks like. And then we take those examples, we retrain our model on them, and the model gets better at delivering great experiences for telco customers.
We're training Telcloud, right? We're going to announce it here at MWC.
Yes.
What's next? I mean, when I look at all of the telco customers that we serve, how do you want AWS to position Telcloud? What is the art of the possible, Will, once this is available for general consumption?
The single challenge stood out is how to achieve innovation at scale. Because there's, you know, companies like Anthropic has very limited resource of top-tier engineers. And there are a lot of, you know, telcos who wanted to tap into this Gen AI's potential. But to achieve the innovation at scale, that's when AWS comes in, your, you know, top-notch cloud capabilities and your AI tools and platform can actually, you know, dovetail with each other to create a kind of, you know, collaboration platform where global telcos can actually tap into.
So what you're basically saying is that any of our telco customers, if they choose, can call this trained telco model and start using it once it's made generally available.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
wow.
We can create very successful collaboration across, you know, CSP, telco, and LLM pioneers. And then creating the successful reference and use cases, we can actually diffuse the innovation at scale.
Sounds really exciting. Thank you for trusting us with the journey that you're both on. And thank you for joining us here, Nirav and Will. Look forward to seeing you around the show and around the industry.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.